What's up, everybody? I just wanted to make a quick video talking about kind of my journey of, you know, how I learned Korean, and then also give you guys some tips and tricks on, you know, just kind of more generally, some things that I think would help out, things that I wish I had known before I started studying Korean, as well as some actual resources that will hopefully be able to help you out a little bit. Just to give you a little bit of background on, you know, why should you listen to me at all when it comes to learning Korean. I lived in Korea for just over 2.5 years, did study abroad there. Majored in Korean university, my wife's Korean, and we only speak Korean in the house. So yeah, I'm fairly fluent at this point. And you know, there's a lot of things that I've learned along the way that I think could be super helpful for someone who's new trying to get into Korean and start studying. So kind of just going through the timeline of how I started learning Korean. I served a mission for my church, a 2-year full-time mission in South Korea. And when I found out that I was going to be going to Korea, you know, was one, you know, shocked, a little bit surprised. We don't get to pick where we go, but found out I was going to Korea. My brother was already in Korea doing the same thing. And so he was able to send me, some resources, some tips and tricks as well. So I was able to start by studying those before I really got to Korea or got to study at all. But that kind of brings me to my first point. The most important thing I feel like if you're going to be studying any language, regardless of, you know, Korean or otherwise, is to really have a purpose behind it. You know, for me, it was, I'm going to be going to Korea for 2 years. I'm going to be living there and talking to people and serving them every day. So, you know, I had that purpose in mind as I was studying Korean. Obviously, it doesn't have to be, you know, such a big and daunting task of going and living in Korea for 2 years, but having some sort of purpose, whether it's, hey, I want to watch this Korean drama and not have to read all of the English subtitles, or I want to be able to read Webtoons when they come out in Korean and not wait 2 weeks for the English translation to come out. You know, whatever it is, have a purpose in mind as you're studying. Otherwise, to be honest, you know, it'll get boring and you'll stop studying. I did the same thing, you know, with Italian or Japanese, or, you know, there's a couple of different languages that I've started studying and then just stopped, because really, if you don't have a purpose, you're not going to keep studying. So really figure out what your purpose is and why you want to learn Korean, and that'll kind of form your foundation for, you know, the motivation to keep studying. So like I said, found out I was going to be going to Korea. My brother, he sent me a vocabulary book and then a recommended dictionary to start reading or to start looking through. And that was great, being able to just get down Hangul. So Hangul is the Korean writing system. It's a phonetic alphabet, kind of like English. So each letter has a specific sound. And so you can learn to read Korean in one day. Like, it's not a super hard language to learn to read, at least. So really, learning to read Korean with Korean, I'd say, is crucial. There is what's called romanization, which is using American or English letters to try and represent Korean words. Just don't even try to do that. I have friends that learned Korean with me that started and were using romanization a lot, and it really hindered their Korean for, you know, the first year and a half of them trying to learn it. They were kind of stuck thinking through the English romanization of the Korean words rather than actually learning to speak Korean. So I'd really focus on learning the sounds that these characters make, learning the sounds of the alphabet, rather than trying to learn, okay, what English letter does this correspond to? So start with that. The vocabulary book that my brother recommended was, it was either 6,000 or 9,000 words in Korean, which is obvious a lot. And it was great, but my problem with that vocabulary book is that it was in alphabetical order. So it was more of a dictionary, honestly, than a vocab book. So I always laugh when I tell people that, you know, my first word I learned in Korean was kagu, which is furniture, which obviously is not the most important word to learn, but it's the the first word that was in that vocabulary book since it started alphabetically. Going along with that, my first recommendation for vocabulary books is this 20,000 Essential Korean Words book. There's a beginner one, an intermediate one. I gave my beginner one to someone else, but this book, it's available on Amazon, and it's fantastic. It's not alphabetized, it's by topic. And so, for example, if you're watching a medical drama and that's your purpose, that's your goal to be learning Korean, like, go to the medical section and start learning some of these terms that you might hear them, you know, saying in the drama. I think that was super helpful to go through topic by topic and get down these words, quiz myself on them, keep them written down. Yeah, I did not do that when I first started studying, and I wish I would have had this. So this is my recommendation as far as vocab book goes. Start with the beginning one, obviously, and get all those words down. So yeah, I started studying on my own, learned how to read Hangul pretty well. started going through that vocabulary book, posting sticky notes all over my house. I was labeling the salt and the, you know, the mirror and all these things. So that's super helpful too. If you can just put sticky notes on stuff to you know, learn what those words are, that helped me a lot. After studying a little bit by myself at home, I went and did what is essentially, you know, an 8-week full-time crash course in Korean before I went to Korea. So, you know, being there was super helpful. Being around a bunch of people who were also studying Korean was nice. But to be honest, it was really more of teaching us how to learn Korean rather than actually teaching us Korean. I'm glad I went, but most of the actual learning Korean happened when I went to Korea. So really, if you can get a chance to go to Korea, even if for, you know, a week or, you know, 2 weeks, the longer you can be there, obviously the better it's going to be. But find a way to get to Korea. Being in Korea, I think I learned more in the first, you know, 3 weeks being in Korea than I did in the first 10 weeks of, you know, studying on my own and studying through that crash course. So definitely find a way to get to Korea. If it's, you know, set a goal for yourself, whether you can go this year or, you know, next year, 2 years from now, whatever it is, like really budget and try and get to Korea. That's super helpful. So I went to Korea. I had, you know, other foreigners that were learning Korean that were better than I was, that I was able to, you know, ask questions to and get feedback on my Korean. And so that's, you know, the next big tip really is to find people that can help you out, whether it's, you know, meeting Koreans and having actual Korean friends that you enjoy spending time with that can help answer your questions, or foreigners who are studying Korean as well. Sometimes, honestly, it's been more helpful to ask a foreigner, especially when you're a beginner, because you'll ask, you know, really basic questions like, hey, why is this, you know, said this way, or why is this that way? And it's the same in English when people ask me questions about English, it's like, I don't know, that's just how it is, right? It's the same thing in Korean. Some of those most basic, you know, questions, Koreans will be like, I don't know, that's kind of how it is, right? So, you know, interacting with other foreigners who have learned Korean, they have come to understand, you know, why things are the way they are, sometimes even better than Korean. So, yeah, find a community, find people either, you know, online, Reddit, there's tons of Discords, tons of places where you can find a community of people who are all studying and learning Korean. That'd be my next tip. The next one is to read. Start reading in Korean. And for me, I had, you know, if I set apart an hour of the day that I said, I'm going to study Korean for an hour, I would break that up and say, hey, I'm going to read for 15 minutes, and then I'm going to go through vocabulary for 15 minutes, and then I'm going to go through grammar for 15 minutes. You know, whatever that time allotment you have is, you know, make sure you're spending some time reading and read out loud. Something that, you know, other people did that I never did personally, but I know a lot of people have a lot of success with, is record yourself reading Korean out loud and then play it back to you. Because you don't really know what you sound like in your own head. So recording that and playing it back is going to give you, you know, better feedback than it is listening to yourself say things out loud. But read out loud. It's going to be super slow at first. I remember I was reading like, it felt like I was reading like 3 words a minute when I started, but you slowly get better. A lot of people don't recommend reading like translations. They'll say, oh, go find an actual Korean book to read. I personally think that reading translations is fine, especially when you're starting off. For me, the first, you know, 5 or 6 books I read were probably translations. And the thing that was nice about that is I had read them in English. And so as I was reading through them in Korean, even if I only knew, you know, 1 or 2 words in a sentence, I knew what chapter I was in, I knew what the book was about, and so I could kind of get a better idea than if I was reading something that I had no idea what it was. So find a book that you're interested in, something that, you know, either you've read in English or you know the story or the background, and read out loud to get some of that reading practice in. One of, you know, my good friends that was amazing at Korean, he told me, he's like, you know, a lot of people focus so much on the speaking and the listening that they never read or write Korean. It's like, yeah, you might be fluent in Korean, but you're illiterate. You know, like that's not a great thing, right? We want to be literate in Korean as well. So make sure you're doing that. The next thing I did, like I said, when I had my language studies, I would break them up to, you know, how much time on reading, how much time on vocabulary, how much time on grammar. There are a couple of, I mean, there's, you know, tons and tons of different grammar books. I had read parts out of the grammar book from like Seoul National University or from some of the other really top universities in Korea. But what I think is the best grammar book for new people is this book right here, Korean Grammar in Use. This one is actually made by the same people, which is why they look the same or similar. And the beginning one, also gave it away to a friend, but there's beginner, intermediate, and advanced. And starting with these books, I think, would have given me a huge head start on learning Korean. I think that beginner book is really easy to understand, covers the basics, give you like the right amount of practice, but also like moves you through it fast enough. So, you know, set up part-time to study grammar and to study vocabulary and to work those things out. These are really, honestly, if someone just had Korean grammar in use and the 2000 essential Korean words, I think like you can get pretty good at Korean just with these two resources. Obviously, like I said, start with the beginner ones, not the intermediate ones. But these would have a huge impact on your Korean studying. outside of that, you know, really, like I said, go to Korea, find a community, find people that you can speak to in Korean, even if it's other foreigners. It is so awkward, like so awkward to speak Korean to foreigners, at least it is for me. When I went to Korea and there were other foreigners that were learning Korean, they'd be like, hey, like let's practice with each other, let's speak Korean to each other. It was like the most awkward thing ever, but do it. Like the more you can speak Korean, the better and the faster you're gonna be. Obviously, it's all about getting like practice hours in. So find, you know, places and people to talk to where you can speak Korean. If you're watching Korean dramas, like just repeat after what they say. repeat what they say. Try and like lock down that pronunciation. And I think you'll go a lot farther, a lot quicker than I did when I first started studying Korean. So hopefully these tips were helpful. Obviously there is so much more to studying Korean than, you know, what I shared here. But as far as getting those basics down and really getting a foundation underneath you, I feel like if you start with, you know, some of those things that I mentioned, you'll be able to get that solid foundation to achieve whatever that goal is that you set at the beginning. I'm sure I missed stuff, but if you have any questions about learning Korean, Korean culture, what it's like living in Korea, definitely leave those in the comments and we'll make some more videos and we'll try and get to those questions for you. If this video was helpful at all, please give me a like and subscribe, and we'll talk to you in the next one. Thanks.